Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Starflame. So guys, in this video I want to talk about Jason Lee saying that Ye West is not married, and Ye West's ex-manager is saying, you know what, that's not the case, and he's given reason why Ye West is actually married. Now, so I was watching The Breakfast Club, and Jason Lee said that Ye West and Bianca is not married. Ye West has been visiting her apartment a lot, yada yada yada. They're talking about, you know, engagement. But if you guys remember, ever since Jason Lee was no longer Ye West's social media manager, he was going, you know, on a smear campaign against Ye. For all those who have been paying attention on Instagram, you know, I called him out on it, and a few of my followers also did, because we could see that in black and white he was actually launching a smear campaign against Ye. It's as though he was mad about something. Then later Armin Wiggins told us that, you know, Jason Lee basically was charging Ye West for work that he didn't do, and as such that's the reason why his contract was not renewed. So as such, when Jason Lee said that Ye West is not married, you know, it's given the sense that he's still bitter, he's still angry, he's still mad at Ye West. Now, many people, they have been saying that, you know what, in the state of California it takes some time to get a marriage license, and I'm saying this is why people need to pay attention to all the details, because Ye West has been in Utah. He has been in Utah for, I think it's over a month, if not close to a month. In Utah, it takes 7 days for you to get a marriage license, maximum 14 days. And once you have someone, you know, who is, you know, on papers that can do the ceremony, then you could have gotten legally married in Utah. So when people are saying, you know what, it's not possible for him to get married in California because of, you know, the laws surrounding marriage license, I'm saying, you know, are you people really thinking? California is not the only place that someone can get married. Also, another thing that people are not paying attention to is the fact that we have seen where things have been different for celebrities. The process, the paperwork, time frame, and all of that is normally different for these, you know, A-list celebrities. So we really have to think about stuff and not jump to the idea of, oh, this is all just a publicity stunt. Because if you really look into it, Ye West is not a man of publicity stunt. Whenever he does something, whenever he says something, he has normally been proven to be correct. Now guys, Ye West's manager, Ari Alexander, his name is Ari, or is it Ali Alexander? Ali Alexander. He basically said that people haven't been paying attention because Bianca and Ye West, they have been wearing their wedding band, and it's not just an engagement ring. And everywhere you see Ye, you see Bianca, and that's the reason why Ye West has been keeping a very low profile. Also, too, this girl has been working with Ye for over 2 years, so it's not possible, it's not impossible for them to have developed a relationship during this time. And based on what Ye West's manager said, Ye and Bianca sees eye to eye on a lot of things as it relates to, you know, creativity, designs, you know, because both of them love to create. If you're not aware, Bianca is a Yeezy architectural designer, so they definitely do have a lot in common. But also on the same hand, we have to remember that opposites definitely do attract. So guys, with all the, you know, everyone being in their feelings and a lot of people having a lot of, you know, negative stuff to say, I think that it is time for us to, you know, give people a chance. It cannot be that every step that this man makes, every step that he takes, is just so wrong about everything. He's wrong for breathing, he's wrong for living. No, the most important thing is that Ye West is happy. The most important thing is that there's no one who can basically say that he's hateful, you know, he's talking trash about people, he's quiet, and he's minding his own business. And also, this young lady, Bianca, she's an Australian. And another thing that I find a lot of people talking about is the fact that this girl is a Kim Kardashian lookalike, when in reality, she looks absolutely nothing like Kim. Bianca is a younger girl. Bianca looks as though she's in her 20s. We know that Miss Kimmy Cakes is in her 40s. And the two looks absolutely nothing alike. And maybe Bianca know that people would have start, you know, be comparing her to Miss Kimmy Cakes. And that's the reason why, you know, we see her with short blonde look. Some people are theorizing that, you know, she went blonde because Kim Kardashian was also blonde. But remember that Kim has gone back to, you know, basically, you know, dyeing her hair black again. So I don't think that that comparison is really logical. And also, Bianca's hair is short now, as we can see. So guys, that's really all I want to talk about. There's nothing else I want to talk about for now, but if something else comes up, I'll come back and let you guys know. So guys, thank you so much for your time. Stay safe, stay blessed. See you all next time. Bye guys.